My name is Rose Robinson. I work for Anita Borg Institute, and our community is Systers, S-Y-S-T-E-R-S. Systers is a community for women in computing. It was started in 1987, and we're 26 years strong this year, and we have about 4,400 plus women across the world. So we have a lot of women who are various computing disciplines, but we're really there just to support each other, help each other through careers, life challenges, professional decisions, just much more. Our students actually are sisters, so we reach out to all of our sisters in the community. And our main goal is actually to do some outreach for women. We want women to be exposed more in open source. So we had about six sisters as students this year that were that started out with just maybe 15 applicants, but we actually had six sisters that were actually in the program. My actual role was org admin, and I was also a mentor. My student was Julia Proft, and she was actually out of Connecticut College. She was very nervous about entering into this program because she felt that it was overwhelmed for her and she didn't have the Python skills. But I have to tell you, by the end of the summer program, she was very, very good in Python and delivered some awesome work. She worked on an admin feature where she actually changed some of our user interface for our requests to join our community. It's very cumbersome. So she actually did a lot of database changes, a lot of UI design, fantastic job.
Google Summer of Code this year for me was my first time as a mentor. I was a student last year and I was way more nervous this year than I was last year. But my student was amazing. She was really smart and everything was just perfect with her. She worked on creating some scripts for reporting about our mailing list, because we have more than one. And all the moderators want some statistics, and also our administrator, Rose. So we work on that together. Well, she did all the work. I was just mentoring, and it was just perfect.
I think I'd love to see sisters more engaged in some of the projects here. We had a couple of sisters that were accepted into two programs, and it was our mission to really get our sisters more exposed to more open source projects. So it was perfectly fine for us that they were exposed and getting engaged with other open source projects. And I think what we will do next year is actually just, you know, inform our community of what other open source projects there are. We found an incredible amount of just science projects, humanitarian projects, a lot of server projects, which were really cool because a lot of sisters are actually into those type of technologies. So I think they would be very excited to see that for next year. If someone wants to get involved with Systers, they can visit sisters.org, S-Y-S-T-E-R-S.org. That is actually our front page of our communities. We have a lot of sub-communities as well that are culturally driven as well as technology driven. So we do have a FOSS community, entrepreneurs, and that's one way to actually join our sisters. And the one engagement that we have from a community standpoint is just communicating with each other and getting and helping each other through a lot of the technology challenges. So we do have a tech talk community, and that helps with different projects, things that they're getting stuck on or need a little bit of help on or a little boost. I've actually been a sister for 13 years now, since 2000, and I believe, my memory serves me correctly, that we started GSOC in 2007, and that was started by Robin Jeffries and Jen Redmond. So we've been part of the GSOC community and family for a few years now. This is my first year as organizational admin as well as a mentor. So I've been involved in Python and a lot of other open source projects, particularly with Mailman as well. So it was a learning experience for me as well, but also is very gratifying.
This is my second year as part of Systers. Last year I was a student with them. That's how I met them, through Google Summer of Code. And this year I was a mentor. And I think being a student is way easier than being a mentor. But because you don't have any, I mean, you just have to work. And being a mentor, you have to be a role model. Mm-hmm. But that's really cool at the same time. So can't wait for next year. And yeah, we hope to get some very good features done next year with the students and just keep growing.
I think what I would love to see next year, and hopefully we can make this happen, is to do some collaboration with other projects here. I'd love to see Systers get involved with some of the science open source, humanitarian open source projects. It's always great. A lot of educators in our community, so I am so looking forward to them getting involved with some of the gaming for the students, because overall I think we can take away from all of this as well and learn and how we can actually help the next generation of Systers as well. So I'm hopeful because I'm also a mother. I'm a mother to a daughter and also a son. So I want to teach both of them that it is very perfectly okay to see women in our roles. As a daughter, I want her to actually pursue any type of technology that she can, because every technology will touch every industry, whatever we're doing. But as my son as well, I want him to be very inviting and help change that environment and just make it more open. I think the next generation is actually going to be very awesome, and I think there's a lot of change in that right now. But I think that next generation is going to be really cool to bring up, have that open next year.